Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions once again, and welcome to another edition of Mail Call. Got several things we need to show you guys, so let's just dive right in and get to it. The first thing I want you to see is this figure right here. This is from a line of figures known as 100 Kingdoms. You can find them at 100kingdoms.com. This particular miniature is called the Flame. Picked him up because he was cheap and cool. That's two of my really good requirements for a nice miniature. Cheap and cool looking. Really sort of a scarred, just fleshed, really ripped and torn and burned looking body. But I like his method of attack. It's very unique. He's got this barrel that fits on his back right there. All right, and just imagine that's going to stay there. And he also carries this torch right here. So basically what he does, he takes somehow the gasoline or oil or whatever it may be out of the barrel on his back, and he blows it across the torch, and that's how he kills his enemies. I think that is freaking awesome. I have never seen anything quite that cool before. But really neat model, fairly well sculpted, not too much flashing on the model. It does fit together okay, but it could be a little bit better. You can see there's a tiny gap in the arm over there. Not the greatest of sculpts, but certainly better than many of the smaller companies have been able to do recently. Again, you can find them at 100kingdoms.com. I would suggest definitely going to check them out, especially for you Mordheim players out there. They have a lot of different factions that you could probably use in your Mordheim warband, or just create your own warband for that matter. But again, really neat little miniature. Looking forward to getting him painted up. Okay, let's see what else we have. I've got... this is a cool one. From Rackham, we have the Black Troll, or the Troll Noir, as the box says. This is just a really, really fun miniature. I've liked this guy ever since they released him. I think this would really make a nice centerpiece to a good orc army. Just having this, I mean, it's a Cyclopean troll, number one, which is cool in and of itself. Secondly, the guy fights with a boat anchor and a severed hand. I mean, how many other guys have you ever seen where the weapon that they're holding is the severed hand of an enemy? That's just absolutely cool. And so, I'm really, really looking forward to getting to this guy and getting him painted up. I'm a little bit hesitant, though. I gotta admit, I am no Rackham painter. And so, I'm not really sure how I'm gonna do all these, like, little color fades and things that Rackham does. I'm always a little scared when I get into the Rackham miniatures that they're not gonna look perfect. But that's okay. That's just one of those things that you have to practice and get over. So, I'm, again, looking really forward to getting onto this guy, because he's a really nice-looking model. Look how detailed he is, too, by the way. Take a look down there on that leg. He actually has mushrooms growing out of his leg, alright? He's got a little barrel down there, all these chains and things like that. Just really, really a neat, neat model. And most of these older Rackham figures you can buy for anywhere between 50 to 75% off retail price. So check eBay and see if you can find some of these older Rackham models, because they are really, really nice. What else do we have? This is cool. Excuse me. Finally got this in from Scale Creep Miniatures. This is the Things That Go Bump in the Night Frankenstein scenario. I will do another video where I actually unbox this and show you guys what's inside. But again, this is from Blue Moon Manufacturing. Tell you what, click Frankenstein right here, and you can be taken. You'll be taken to that Friday afternoon figures where we actually reviewed and showed you guys some of the Blue Moon Manufacturing stuff. I'm interested to get into this box because it says set contains 12 unpainted 28mm figures. Well, if you count the actual people, there's 12. But on the front of the box, you also see this table here and this table here. So if you add those together, you'd find 14. So I'm interested to see if this is just placed here for scenery or if you actually do get them in the box. I hope you get them because it's always good to have a little bit of extra scenery laying around. But, again, I'll be interested to see what's in this thing, and I'll do another video where we actually unbox it and kind of go over the miniatures and see how well they're sculpted and that sort of thing. Speaking of scenery, by the way, stay tuned because Christopher does scenery here coming up very, very soon. All right, what else here? I can show you guys those guys a little bit later. Let's get to the Wood Elf Army before I run out of time. We are almost done with the Wood Elf Army. I've got two figures that I've got to find, and then we'll be done. I got to get two Spell Singers. These came in. These are old-school Warhawk Riders. I've got two Warhawk Rider Champions. Let me zoom in on these guys so you can kind of see. Let me find... let's see here. This guy kind of... of course, he wants to hide. There we go. You can kind of see him right there. Is that dude, too? Let me see if I can get a better shot on this one. I always hate blister packs like this because you can't ever see the model. There we go. You can kind of see him a little bit better up there. It's a sort of a Valkyrie-style miniature with a sword raised high like that. These guys are going to be used as the leaders of my two units of Warhawk Riders. I think they're called Wind Riders. I can't remember offhand what the codex says, but that's what they're going to be used for. And I also picked up this other guy right here. This is a Warhawk Rider with bow, just an old-school miniature. My only concern with these models is they come with actual flying bases, while the newer ones come with just a standard black 40mm base and a flying stand. So what I'm probably going to end up doing is buying a bag of 40mm bases and just throwing these flying stands to the side and using the 40mm bases. That way everything ranks up nicely. On the table next, let's see. Another Wood Elf thing. Good Tree Man, alright? Like this guy, that's going to be a nice little centerpiece style, or a second centerpiece, I guess I should say, because the dragon's going to be the big centerpiece. But that'll be fun to have in the army. Another unit of Dryads, or another 12 guys. We're not going to be using the whole set, but another box of those guys. And let's see. Oh, yes, of course. You guys remember that little problem that I was having with the Wood Elf horses, their faces being covered up and looking really, really ridiculous? I fixed the problem, and I fixed it by going very, very old school and picking up some Dark Elves. All right, I picked up two Dark Elf Riders. All right, I'm sorry, one Dark Elf Rider Champion, one Dark Elf Rider Standard Bearer, and then a box of Dark Elf Riders. Now, I got to tell you guys, this set right here, this is what got me into wargaming. The first time I saw this set sitting on a shelf in my local game store, I was very, very just blown away. I looked at those guys, I was like, man, that looks so cool. I wonder what that game's like. Now, of course, it took me another 3 years to get into the game because I didn't have any money at the time. But very cool set. What I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to be doing head swaps. Take a look at that guy's head right there. Much more suitable. Nice open head like that. I'm not exactly sure I like the growling look, but that's actually the way all the old school horses looked anyway. Let me see if I've got the other one. Here's the other one. He's got actually more of a closed mouth. And then I've got four more of the exact same sculpts basically in this box. And what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking those heads and doing a little bit of copying and casting work on those heads, and that way I don't have to scavenge from these sets. I can just cast them and then put the originals back with the sets and then paint these guys up separately. But in getting the heads, I figured, hey, may as well pick up an entire unit of Dark Riders. All right, so the only thing I'm missing is a musician, but we'll pick one of those up later maybe. All right, let's see, what else do we have? Actually, I think that's it. I did get these here. I'll show you guys these real quickly, and then we'll end. This is two old-school boxes of Wood Elf Archers, what will be known now as Glade Guard. Eight figures apiece. I don't know if these are going to go in the army or not. We're going to see. It kind of depends on how much flexibility I have with the point values and everything like that. I think I can fit them in, but we shall see. Anyway, that is it for right now. Let me put the coolest thing I think that we have out here. That's going to be the Black Troll right there. It'll give us a nice ending picture. But I hope you guys have enjoyed today's issue of Mail Call. And I really hope you've seen a lot of cool figures. Maybe inspired you to go out and get some nifty stuff that you hadn't known about before. But that's it for right now, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day. And I'll see you next time.